Good evening, YouTube. Thanks for stopping back into the channel tonight, right here with Rust Belt Mechanic. So tonight we've got another episode of Nifty Tools of the Week. I know how much you guys absolutely love those. This week we picked up some really good deals off of the truck here and around. This is going to be some really good nifty tools. Stay tuned. First nifty tool this week we're going to come to is this 23-piece Red Helix titanium drill bit set from Milwaukee. I actually ended up picking this up off of our Snap-on truck. He's one of our extra distributors for Milwaukee, and he had these things sitting on the truck. Now here in the shop, I did kind of a comparison test between these and the newer Matco Hyperstep drill bits. I kind of did the comparison because these have an extra little tip that highly resembles that of the Matco Hyperstep. Yes, the Hyperstep does have like four different lands on it. This one has the one extra one, so you've got four facets of surface. It's gonna drill into each one of the things that you drill into faster. The pilot hole from the centering portion of it is going to go in quicker, and it's also going to leave your drill bits sharper for a longer amount of time because it does have more surfaces to have to wear down over time. Now this one, why I absolutely love it is because of the hex drive to it. A lot of the smaller things that I do drilling wise here in the shop is for just small things, grounds, installing small things within and under dashes, things like that. I'm not doing any kind of really heavy duty drilling, not nearly as often as I'm using the smaller quick to access things, especially if I'm using the new Milwaukee Fuel 2505. I'll be doing a review with this one here later, but that combination with that hex drive with these is just absolutely amazing. On top of that, the price point on these is killer as well. I picked these up for 20 bucks. So $20 gets me a good set of drill bits that's well-deserved, long-lasting, as compared to the Matco Hypersteps. That set was well over $300. Yes, I know there's a huge difference in warranty and what the product is, but for the small things that I'm using them for, not really breaking a lot of stuff all the time. That's why for those small things, I'll end up going with the Milwaukee. Second up on our nifty tools of the week, we have this 7-piece stubby 3/8 drive Torx bit socket set from Snap-on. Part number on this one is 207EFTXYSE. Now, whenever I'm doing brakes or anything like that, these Torx bits are one of the hardest used tools that I ever use. Most of the time I'm using an impact on them, and a lot of the time these aren't even impact rated, a lot of the other ones from Snap-on. Now, with the whole process of physics, since you have less twisting going on because your impact mass is further out on a normal bit, this one you're gonna bring that impact closer into where your socket portion is gonna be holding onto the bit, so therefore it will twist less and hopefully therefore crack and break apart a whole lot less as well. Now in a future video that you guys are gonna see, I end up using these on a big brake kit for our side-by-side project. I ended up breaking like three other Torx bits. It was a huge, massive headache, just a pain in the butt, and these are what came through. I got so much of a headache off of doing that video. So I ended up calling up my rep in the middle of that video and saying, hey, I am so done breaking these 30 Torx bits that I just need another one like right now. So these got me through that video, and these have also gotten me through work here the last couple of weeks without any breakage at all. Now these all fit into the 7-piece magnetic tray little socket set, magnetic anywhere you guys put it, anything like that. It's gonna stick there. It also unfortunately does hold onto any of the other metal debris that you guys have on your socket, so watch out for that one. But I do like these because I can stick them just about anywhere. They are all 3/8 drive, so big plus on that one. That's majority of the time what I'm using the Torx bit sockets for. Now for the bad part. MSRP on these is gonna run you $208, but because this video is all about the deals that I was able to get on trucks lately, which is something that you need to really look into with your representatives on whatever tool truck it might be, you can usually talk them down out of a certain percentage that they're gonna get if you're buying certain things, maybe buying more than one thing on the truck at a time. So this one, I was actually able to talk my Snap-on rec down to $150. So $150 off the Snap-on truck, I thought was a killer deal for this Torx bit set. Now, third up on our nifty tools of the week list is going to be this 7-piece snap ring plier set from Snap-on. Like I said before, the way I'm able to get some of these great deals was getting multiple things off the truck at the same time. So I ended up picking up the Torx bit set and this set off of the truck at the same time, ended up getting two really great deals. Talk about the deal on that one here in a second, but this 7-piece set, ended up picking it up in dark gray. I absolutely love that color from Snap-on. Picked these up because I have been absolutely frustrated and hate using my old snap ring pliers. The old ones that everyone seems to have are these old like Craftsman switchable reversing snap ring pliers with the little detachable ends that come out. They always end up bending, breaking, and you can never find the sets to replace those ends, so it's just a pain in the butt and get rid of them. The other ones that I had were these smaller mid-size Blue Point set. They were just made of really thin cheap steel, and it doesn't matter how tight I tightened down the little tightening tabs, that they always ended up bending on the ends or breaking the tips off before I even got a snap ring halfway loose. So again, these, throwing those out the door. So with this set, we ended up picking up each one of the main sizes, 1, 2, and 3, have their different respective sizes at their different angles. And what I really like about these is they're reversible on every single one of them. Now, respectively, with each one of these sizes, you are able to reverse them from spreading outwards to pushing inwards. On the Blue Point ones before, you had to unscrew a little dial tab. These just have a little push pin in the center section, and then you are able to pull apart the top part of the plier, and then all you have to do is insert it into the other open end, and it's automatically working. Really quick and easy to be able to switch these back and forth without having to unscrew things all over the place. Each one of these sizes is sized absolutely perfectly, and the tips on these are hardened as well. As you can see with the smaller ones, the 070 size, inside and out, I do like that the tips have a slight angle to them on the inside portion, helpful for grabbing a lot of those larger pins and snap rings in some of the earlier transmissions that I'm used to working on. So great deal, I ended up picking these up. These originally on the Snap-on truck were $228. I know, for you guys who don't use snap rings a whole lot, that is quite a bit of money. And like I said, I use these on transmissions quite often. So picking these up is gonna save me a lot of time in the first place, but $228 was quite a steep price. I actually ended up getting these talked down all the way down to $175. That, I think, is a steal for this set from Snap-on, so you might wanna check these out. Fourth and final tool set on our nifty tools of the week is going to be this 13-piece 3/8 impact socket set that's also magnetic from Matco Tools. Now, I ended up picking this one up after I did the video, if you guys saw, of me changing out my top from the Snap-on box. I ended up lifting it up out of the way. Well, before I could lift everything up out of the way, I had to get the bolts that were kind of a pain coming from the locker into the hutch area. They're recessed in there about 2 inches or so, and in the video I ended up dropping 2 of the bolts down into the cabinet. It took me like 25 minutes to get those bolts out, and it pissed me off so badly because I didn't have the correct 13 millimeter magnetic socket to be able to take care of that. So I got looking around. I first priced the Snap-on set of these, and wow, we'll just say that those were a little bit on the outrageous side at over $320 for their set. So I ended up going over to Matco and picked up this ADV set impact sockets that are magnetic from Matco. This is a 13-piece set running from 7 millimeter all the way up to 19 millimeter. No skips within these. 150 degree chamfer on the edges of it, so it's able to slip onto any fastener pretty easily. And then within 1/2 of an inch, you're gonna get to the magnet on the end, so it's gonna hold on to any of the fasteners. I've seen a couple of them where people have put deep sockets onto these, and you know, for the automotive application, there's just really no need for a deep magnetic socket set where we're going. So these are absolutely killer. On the side of each one of these, you can see in gold lettering both the brand and the size on each one of them, and it comes in this nice blow molded case, so you can take it anywhere you want. Personally, I'm probably not gonna keep it in the blow molded case, case. I'm going to get some new socket organizers for this because honestly, the blow molded case just takes up too much space in the toolbox. But having a really nice impact rated magnet set works amazingly. You would be surprised at the amount of things that I've just automatically use this for now. Instead of using my stubby impact sockets, these come in great handy, especially when I'm using a long extension trying to get some bolts off of an exhaust manifold or a flange coming out from doing a cylinder head on a Hemi. Use these instead, and after you get the fasteners off, the bolts and stuff aren't flying in every which way. You have them right there. Also great for putting in bell housing bolts, especially with that long extension. Again, great idea to be able to have a set like these. Now, normally, like I said, pretty expensive from the Snap-on. These were a little bit better at $174.95 retail MSRP. But like I said, I was able to pick up some really good deals over the last couple of weeks, and I ended up picking these up for $125. That's $50 off their normal MSRP pricing, which I thought was a great deal, and I absolutely had to have them for any of my future projects, just like this one, so I wouldn't run into any more headaches. That's why I think you guys should check them out. Now, I know I'm probably gonna catch a lot of hell on this video because a lot of these companies don't like you saying how much you got it for unless it was the full MSRP pricing, because prices may vary. It varies by region, and yes, it does, and yes, it's going to. For most of you guys who go onto the truck, you may not even see the MSRP prices. You may see prices maybe even better than that. One of the biggest things that's gonna come into focus on that is your relationship with your tool guy. Fortunately, for me, I have great relationships with the tool truck drivers that I have that come here. I buy things quite often, as you guys can see, and for a lot of the times they throw me some great deals on these tools, something that I think a lot of other guys can pick up on. You just need to be able to negotiate maybe a little bit with those tool truck drivers. If there's sometimes when you really need one tool, but you don't need it exactly right then, maybe it's on your want list, and you can maybe hold off on that one when you can purchase maybe one or two other things along with that tool that you want at the same time, they're a lot more likely to give you guys a discount on one or more of those tools that you purchase if you're purchasing more than one of them at a time. So maybe just another thing to keep in mind when you're purchasing tools off the tool truck. Well, guys, that's about all I've got for you tonight in the way of nifty tools. Hopefully these tools were able to help you guys out, and hopefully some of that advice was able to help you out as well when purchasing some tools off of the tool truck. Make sure you guys stay tuned for more great content coming down the line. The channel is going to go through some massively fun changes over the next couple of weeks, so definitely stay tuned. Turn on that bell notification so you get notified when I come out with cool, awesome content just like this one here today. I appreciate it, and as always, you guys stay awesome.
90 foot-pounds, we gotta torque these wheels to 90 foot-pounds, 90 foot-pounds, 90 foot-pounds. Oh, what was it again? 90 foot-pounds.